Hey guys, today we're going to be taking out my K&N intake and we're going to be comparing this new Airaid to the factory one as it's an in-between. That way we can get a little more performance compared to stock, but we still maintain the same serviceability. Whenever working on a vehicle, especially a vehicle with electric fans, always disconnect the negative terminal first, just for safety. From a performance aspect, I have no issues with K&N's FIPKs. This thing's been in the truck for, you know, quite a while now, actually. I've had it since, within the first 2 months of owning the truck, I've had it in there, and reliability-wise, I've had zero issues with it. The only issue I had was with the maintenance. Now, what I like about the K&N is it comes with a velocity stack. If you don't know what a velocity stack is, see here it's tapered, so it allows air to come in more smoothly. What I didn't like was this filter is clamped on. You can see this little ring here onto here. What you're supposed to do is you're supposed to loosen this and then twist it off. It doesn't come off that easily, and I was too afraid I was just going to wreck it because this adapter's on the mass airflow. So what I would do every time I had to service it was I would unbolt it off the mass airflow, and I'm spending 15-20 minutes, you know, trying to get this stupid thing off as opposed to the stock airbox. That's my only complaint. On a daily driven truck where I'm not racing anyone, I don't need this filter. Now, I've seen on the new Z28, they actually use a filter like this from factory, so this probably does make a difference in terms of power. But as a blend of performance and serviceability, I don't like this. What I do like though, the main thing was the tube. The tube is much less complicated, and this is probably where you're getting most of your gains, is you're removing all that restriction. If I were to give this system one more con, I did drive through a big puddle and I noticed there was some water underneath the filter and I got a little bit paranoid. So I built this panel out of ABS plastic. You can see I used a cardboard template initially and I made all the notches so it fit nicely, and then I drilled all these holes to let air come through, and I drilled these two holes to use the factory bolts. It is a little bit more effort, but if you are using your truck in off-road situations, I would build something like this. That way when you're going through big puddles or any kind of water at a fast speed, you're not throwing any water up at the filter, because the way the factory filter picks up air, it's very high and it's in the fender away from any kind of water, keeping it dry. So this is what I switched up to. It's from Airaid, and these guys seem to be the only ones that make a modular intake tube. So you keep the factory airbox and then you get rid of all the stupid factory baffling, and then you just have this, which is similar to the cold air intakes or short ram air intakes that you see, but it keeps it much more simple, and then you can just use regular parts on the filter side. I got this part from REV Performance. Now I do have a full video on how to remove this and install an MIT tube. We did it on an older truck. The concepts are still exactly the same, but we're gonna go over and release this clamp over here. This clamp, pull out this whole assembly and put in the new one. It's easy. Now all we have to do is install these couplers. They're all provided in the kit with stainless steel clamps, and they go onto the throttle body and onto the factory airbox. Keep in mind that there are two different sizes, so read the instructions because they're labeled for sizing, and they will. You can make either one work, but if this says 60 on one and 64 on the other, just use whatever the manufacturer is suggesting. When putting on any kind of modifications like this, really look at how it's being installed, because if you fold the coupler, you're going to create a vacuum leak, and then you're going to lose performance, you're not going to have a good piston ring seal, and you might also throw an engine code. So we have to make sure we have a good seal, just like factory. One thing I always make sure when I put couplers on, make sure the fasteners are easy to get at. So I realize it's going to be easier here as opposed to having them over here. And same thing on here, I preferred them on this side. It doesn't really matter over here, that's just my preference. So whenever you're putting these guys on, make sure that you can easily access them if you ever had to service this. Make sure you also install this sticker for emissions, that way you remain CARB compliant. I'm just gonna put it right here all the way, but that way in case anyone needs to make any inspections, they can see this. After installing it, we have gone ahead and started the motor and we're listening for any leaks. It makes like a whooshing sound. You can't put your hand around it, but be careful of the fan or any pulleys and belts. Other thing I did was over here, it was pretty hard to install it, so I put a little bit of silicone lube on the outside just to help it slip in better. And you want to make sure it mates up very close to it. It has to go right up against this little flange right here. We're looking good. Well, here's our new intake tube. So here's the factory airbox. We don't have to worry about water splashing in or anything. It's shielded away from the engine compartment. It's easy to service with just these four Torx on here. We can always remove it. You can drop in an Airaid filter, K&N, factory, whatever you want to do. What I usually do personally is I run a K&N, but I have a Fram filter sitting around. So when I clean my K&N, I can drop in the Fram, clean the K&N, oil it, let it sit for a day or two, and then I drop it back in, and then I take the Fram out. That way I can keep operating my pickup. The other nice thing about the Airaid that the K&N FIPK didn't have is that support, that little radiator support with the little plug, actually plugs back into the Airaid tube. So it's just like factory, but you can see how simple it is. This is similar to what we do on G35s. We take the intake tube off a 350 because it's like this. Because on the G35, it's got all this weird baffling, and all this baffling does is it heats up the air to make the intake quieter. That's all it does. So you're technically heating up the air just by keeping this factory one in here. This is nice and simple, and it works. To see what else I'm up to, make sure to check out my Instagram and Facebook, AnthonyJ350, and check out my website at www.gofasthavefun.ca.